DIY, narinig niyo na ba yun? Do it yourself kung tawagin. With the technology we have now, where all the information you need is at your fingertips. Aba, sobrang dali nang mag-DIY. Beauty, home and gardening, arts and crafts, whatever it is, kaya nang ma-achieve. So, what's DIY? It's a philosophy, a mindset, a lifestyle. It's all the things that you make or do yourself rather than buying them ready-made or paying some professional to do it for you. Ako ha, sa makeup tutorials ko sa YouTube, obvious naman na lahat ay ginawa in the spirit of DIY. Nagsimula nga ako with just a simple camera setup. Kasi rin ngayon, sa panahon ng internet and online videos, there's no limit to what you can explore, what you can learn, and read up on. Ang saya, di ba? Ito ang isa sa mga talagang kahanga-hanga dito sa mundo ng DIY, si Sunshine Teodoro.
DIY is making something with passion from the things that you can find in your house, in your environment. For me, especially for me, I do upcycling. It's destroying something and then creating something beautiful and unique. It's really a challenge for plus-size women like me who wants to dress up well and look good because first, the sizes are limited. Second, it's very expensive. And I wanted to look good in my size, at the same time, express myself through what I wear. DIY makes the world more colorful and interesting.
DIY doesn't have to be your job, your racket, or your side hustle. For some people, DIY is talagang more about giving things a personal touch. Take your cue from Katrina Lapus of Handmade by Kat.
When I got the news that I'll be getting a baby girl, I got so excited. So I went straight to YouTube. I searched for lessons on how to do crochet. Rewarding siya. Una, kasi yung self-fulfillment, parang yes, I did it. Self-discovery din na I'm testing my limits. Yung hearing from your family, thank you, mommy, it's very beautiful. Aww. Or thank you, mommy, I love it. What I'm imparting to her is the importance of doing something handmade is much more valuable because you're investing not only your money, actually, your time, your devotion in that project. So teaching DIY for me is a very fulfilling thing.
This right here is Victoria Mostoles. Stationery's fascinated her since she was young, and now she makes notebooks and notebook covers for her brand.
For me, yung DIY, therapy siya and creative outlet for most of us. And it also motivates other people to start working on their projects. For me, yung DIY community online, sobrang helpful sila. Sobrang mabait lang talaga sila. Lahat ng ideas and projects, sinishare pa nila via YouTube or Facebook and hindi sila nagdadamot. Since parang meron ka talagang support groups na matatakbuhan anytime you want to reach out or you have questions, sobrang fascinating lang and heartwarming ng community. For me, DIY is sharing a part of yourself to others.
Another person who has embraced the DIY philosophy is Tessa Cunanan. This woman is DIY through and through. May mga pa-workshops pa siya. Truly inspiring if you ask me.
Malaki yung naging role nung internet para makabalik ako sa pagdi-DIY. Nakikita ko yung mga tutorial videos, mas madali na bumalik dun sa craft kasi somehow medyo mas mabagal po siguro yung progress when you study DIY on your own or doing crafts on your own in general. But it's discovering the whole process and the craft itself that's rewarding talaga. Now that I'm doing workshops for calligraphy, nakikita ko kung paano napagsasama-sama nung isang art yung mga people of the same interest. Tapos nagiging friends sila, nagkakaroon sila ng mga Facebook groups where they share their experiences or yung mga learnings. DIY helps connect people to others that they can share their growth and passions with.
Do it yourself. Even just hearing about it is already motivating. It's exciting because if you think about it, the internet is one big community of DIY creators.
For me, the most important thing is you just have to go for it kasi you'll never know hanggang hindi mo tinatry.
If you want to create something unique, you have to gather everything that you know, that you see, and then try to create something new and unique for yourself.
Work with what you have. Huwag silang matakot na maging beginners. Eventually, you'll grow into the crafter na you want to become. So, huwag lang matakot magsimula. Another is, love your own style. Huwag na huwag kang mahiya na ilabas yung personality mo. Kasi kaya mo nga siya dini-DIY. You want to do it yourself. You want to do it your own way with your own style.
DIY is limitless. You might be thinking that I might be too late to learn something new. No. DIY doesn't consider what age you are at now. Never be afraid to test and explore.
Many wonderful possibilities await when you do things yourself. And this is just a glimpse into the fun, colorful world of DIY. I'm Anne Clutz, and this is my vision. What's yours?